Ridiculous question or remark.
Sarcastic stormtrooper statement.
Reluctant response and spike the camera. Hey y'all, I'm Josh. This is Josh Build Stuff. Who else were you expecting? If you watched our latest video, you might have noticed that I just got back from a trip to California. We went to Legoland and Disneyland, and while there, I bought a bunch of stuff. So I thought I would show you all the stuff that I bought in this video here today. Let's get right into it. Let's start off by something I didn't buy, but something that I would almost call priceless or worthless, depending on who you are. This is the 501st Battle Pack. I actually brought this with me. It's signed by none other than the one, the only, it's Sans, which I think it's funny because Sans is a friend of Ryan, and Ryan from M&R Productions, he had the whole idea of the 501st Battle Pack. This set is entirely because of him. Give him more credit. Lego does not give him enough credit, so I thought it'd be funny to get a signature from someone who knows Ryan on the battle pack. I don't know, I'll get Ryan's signature on this eventually, but I got that signed by Sans. He was with us on the trip. Moving on, I also got some roses. These have been hard to find in Lego stores lately, and so I was like, I'll pick these up while I'm at the Legoland Lego store. Basically, I was just trying to buy things that are hard to find or that I haven't seen at other Lego stores. I also bought some things from Disneyland in here. One of those things from Disneyland is, this came in a little Disneyland bag. This is one of the few things I actually bought from Disneyland because it is themed to the Nautilus from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. These are like little metal earth things. I've gotten one of them in the past. They're actually pretty tedious and annoying to assemble in the end. They're like very small little tabs that you need very small little tweezers and a lot of dexterity and a lot of patience and time to put these things together. But this is one of the very few Nautilus and 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea things themed things that I found in the parks at all. So I had to pick that up. I think that's all that's in that bag. Also from Disneyland, I got this. It is a little restraining bolt for a droid, and I think around the edge in Arabesh it says something like Droid Depot, Galaxy's Edge, or Batuu, or something relating to that. It's actually a little magnet. You could stick it to something, but I just thought that would look fun and be cool to display on my shelves. Continuing on, I'm just grabbing things out of this bag at random. There were a bunch of things. This is like a little Unikitty, I don't know, microscope or something or another. It was like $5. I think it was discounted. Yeah, look, it was on sale for $5. So I picked this up because why not? Because Sans walked up to me. He's like, these are only $5. And I was like, I've learned a lot about you as a person and your character at this point in time, and I will join you on this $5 journey. This is a bag of peanuts that I bought at the airport on the way back. I guess cashews, not peanuts. What am I, crazy? I bought this in case I got hungry on the plane ride back. I didn't actually end up opening them. This is one of several kyber crystals that I bought. If you don't know, a kyber crystal is the crystal that powers a Jedi's lightsaber. You may notice a little bit of redundancy here. So I picked up a yellow kyber crystal, which is already out of its case. It is over here because you use these actual little kyber crystals. They have a little RFID chip in them, and you can use them inside a lightsaber that you would build at Galaxy's Edge. But you're wondering, why did I buy several red ones? Well, if you buy a red one, you have a chance to get a black one, which is like more rare. And I was like, I'll just buy one on eBay. And then ones on eBay are like $500. And so I took the chance of paying $18 each for these. Spoiler, they're both red ones. So now I have three red kyber crystals, but I do have all of the alternate colors because yellow was the last color that I needed to complete that collection. Continuing in our bag of goodies are some video badges. These are kind of a source of drama. So this VIP badge was one that Sans had gotten and printed out for us to hopefully get us a better chance at getting like some autographs from the DJ Llama. And this one was a badge that Legoland was actually giving out. Here's the kicker. On the back of that, there's an autograph area right there. And yet the dang Llama was very reluctant to give out autographs. I got one, but then like when Sans tried to get one, and when Michael tried to get one, and when Claire tried to get one, they like the Llama walked away and they said, we can't give autographs. And so it was a whole dang situation. So I got these as a nice little memento to remember this journey by always. Continuing on, this was another gift from friends. These are like little video, I don't remember what they're actually, they're like little shoelace attachment points. I think these are like rare or hard to get. Sans had gotten these from somewhere and was kind enough to share them with all of us. So that was a cool little memento. Let's reach deeper into the bag. Let's see, we've got chapstick, because in Southern California, man, the air like got cold in the evenings and my lips got chapped in the evening, so I had to buy some of that. On to some actual more Lego. I got this like this Ninjago, I think these are like blister packs. I think these were older. These were probably out from a while ago, but I picked them up because, like I said, I haven't seen these in other Lego stores. That the same goes for these like Lego Movie 2 blister packs, because I hadn't seen these in Lego stores recently. They got the little baby dudes. I've bought a lot of these blister packs lately, and so these are some that I assume that I'd missed out on that this Legoland store was still carrying. Let's see, more chapstick. I bought a 3-pack, so that's not really surprising that that's in there. Here's another poly bag. This one is a Ninjago poly bag. Again, if it's like $5 and it's Lego, I will buy it. And I don't have this poly bag, and so I went ahead and picked one of those up. Continuing on with the blister packs, here's like a Lego Batman series blister pack with a couple of really cool looking minifigures in there. I like this one. This is like the Dream Batman from that one movie, so that's another one that I'm glad to have. Here's like, I think these were seasonal. This is like Halloween build a minifigure, but these were already pre-assembled that were sitting out there for you. So there's like a tiger guy with a pumpkin, a skeleton dude, a little... I call this a witch. I think it's a warlock wizard. I think it's supposed to be a dude, and he has a trident. So that's pretty cool. I also tried to find some actual Legoland souvenirs. So this is like a little Legoland magnet, I believe it's supposed to be, but it's a minifigure, and he says, "I heart Legoland," and I wanted things that actually said Legoland on them when I bought them. So this is one that I'm glad I picked up. There was, let's see if I can find it. This one as well is another like Legoland souvenir pack. I think it comes with stickers for all the different Legoland locations, but this is another magnet, so I picked both of those up together. Don't worry, there's still more in the bag. I also picked up this dude because I like the Stormtrooper stuff in general. This is like, I think he's supposed to be like First Order Stormtrooper Executioner dude, but he's got a little flashlight in his feet when you push his belly. I actually have a regular old TK Trooper, I think in this same model, but Sans was saying that the arms of this guy can be put on a regular scale minifigure. We were reluctant to test that out, but I may test that out myself in a little while here. Another poly bag slash extra bag. This one has like little sports memorabilia, little things, little hockey sticks and skis and other random things. Again, something else that you don't see in every Lego store, so I went ahead and picked one of those up while I was there. Let's reach even deeper into the bag. Here is, this one's weird. It's like an unlabeled poly bag, but it's like, I think it was a seasonal reindeer. Maybe it was a gift with purchase. Maybe it just, I don't know. It's harder to find now. So I picked one of these up while I was at the store, because again, I haven't seen that one around, at least not lately. Let's keep going. Another random little poly bag. This one you can build some, I don't know, random little things. It's something I haven't seen other places. Stop judging me. I can feel you judging me. Here's another extra one. So the other extra was like sports things. This one is, I don't know, like little city accessories. I don't know what they actually call this, but it's like a bicycle and little umbrellas and little just things that you would have around a city. I like this extra series. I wish Lego would do more with that. Just like give me little like parts packs, basically. I will buy those. Here's one that I thought was cool, unique, not really Lego. I think these are pins. I'm not going to use them as pins. I just like this weird like medium scale Lego lightsaber scale, because it's like, it's fun. I have no idea what I'll do with these, but they look cool. And again, oh man, these were $14. Ooh, I thought these were like $5 to $7. Man, I was kind of caught up in the moment, I guess. While I was there, we were all buying stuff, filling our carts and armfuls full of stuff. And I guess I may have gotten a little caught up in the Legoland frenzy now that we're talking about this one. This one was not packaged by Lego, but when I went to Legoland, the whole thing was that we were trying to get a signature from this stupid llama. And I know I own this llama already, but I couldn't find him before leaving. And so I bought a brand new llama bandmate, whatever these things are called. I bought a brand new one of these things upon arriving at downtown Disney's Lego store. And I paid full price for it. So I bought this for $20. I did get my backplate signed. It is right here. There's the llama. There's the backplate. I got that signed by the llama himself. I talk about that a little more in the last video that we made. So I had to buy the whole thing in order to get this thing to get the dude to sign. This one I'm actually excited about. It is like a little Legoland actual Lego set. Recently, Target started carrying a couple of Legoland sets, but this one I've not seen in any actual stores. I think this is supposed to be based on like the castle themed roller coaster at Legoland, which was actually not running at the time that we were there. But even so, I think this is a cool little Lego souvenir. I look forward to actually building this one, even if it's just for myself. Again though, looking at the price, was that $20? I don't know if I paid full price for that, because $20 for that set seems steep for the size of that set. We're down to our last item. The only thing left in that bag are receipts and maybe a little bit of regret. This is a special little box from, it's actually from the Lego store at Downtown Disney near Disneyland. What they have there is the Design a Minifigure Experience. What that means is that you get to basically make a custom Lego minifigure torso, and then you can also pick out the rest of the accessories that go along with him. So I built this little dude myself. Rather, I designed him myself. I don't know how well this will show on camera. I may cut in some B-roll here, but basically I got to design the torso of this little dude. The rest of it were just like regular minifigure parts. So on the front, I went with like a classy classic sweater, and then I wanted him to have like a little JBS some representation right there on the chest, and I put a little brick behind it like as a name tag. I went with a white sweater because you couldn't change the color of the arms, and so I knew the arms were gonna be white, so I picked a white torso. I know obviously you could change out the arms. On the back, there was this cool little tool belt that I actually really liked, and I like this whole like Josh build stuff kind of motif going on, because I do actually build stuff in real life that uses real life tools, not just Lego. I picked a little minifigure head that had a little minifigure mustache, which I liked, kind of like utilitarian blue jeans legs. And you also got to pick a couple of accessories. Sans, who is like ever the Lego strategist, he was like, design the torso, whatever you want, and then just pick like the rarest pieces that you can find out of like the rest of the accessory pieces. And I was like, I don't know, I'll just pick the ones that I think look cool and are fun for me. So here's what I tried to do. Like, I grabbed a toolbox because again, Josh builds stuff. I grabbed a little fedora, cowboy hat, Indiana Jones looking hat, because that does look cool. And in all honesty, I think I do have a headpiece that I would rather use for this little dude. And then I grabbed a little computer because I work on a computer just like for my job and stuff. So I was like, little toolbox building stuff in real life, little computer building stuff on the internet. And then it comes with this little like accessory brick there that says Lego Anaheim on it. And then on the back, you get to print whatever name you want. I printed Josh Mosh, which is like my other online alias that isn't Josh Build Stuff. Also, there was a character limit, so I went with that one. So that was my little design a minifigure dude. I don't think it was that expensive. I think it was like $12 to $15 to make this little dude. So you needed a reservation, but I would recommend doing it if you're at a Lego store that offers this this cool little experience, because not all Lego stores do. And so that's all the stuff I bought. It was really just like a bunch of poly bags. I didn't actually plan to spend that much money at Legoland or on this trip in general. I think this was still all like $150 to $200 now that I'm looking back at the actual receipts, but it could have been much, much worse considering where we were at the time. So this is everything I bought. I hope you enjoyed coming along this little journey with me. I hope you'll check out my previous video where I tell you more of the details about our trip in general, and I hope you'll like and subscribe to this channel. As always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.